Try and get into it. I bought a
You're gonna start doing vlogging, Max?
I'd like to. This is Max.
Max is a Paramotor pilot with the Challenge Club.
How's it going?
Yeah, you're gonna start doing vlogging, you reckon?
I don't know. I'm no Tucker Gott. I think I'll get a camera more for pictures, just taking it from the air.
Get
some nice ones.
This is your new machine. It's a bulldog, isn't it? You happy with it?
I love it. Yeah. The Atom 80 is an absolute beaut. I love it.
It's a nice motor, that, isn't it?
Yeah, it's super quiet, super smooth, easy to start. That was a big thing for me because I'm not very strong. I don't have a great technique at starting it. This is very easy. I can almost
do it. You want to read more meters?
Hey, you remember? Yeah, that's right.
He's all mic'd up. Oh, another update for the Paramotor. Oops, another update for the Paramotor is I got myself a set of these G7s as well. And we're going to fly tonight. We're going to have comms, aren't we, Tom?
Possibly.
You flying later?
Yeah.
If the wind drops a bit. It's a bit stiff at the moment, isn't it?
Drop?
It's a bit stiff at the moment. So it should be a good night tonight because a few of us are camping over. There's Andy Bex, he's over there in his van. Tony's camping. Clive's camping. One or two of us probably going to join us. I've done the service on my motor. I changed the exhaust bushing yesterday. This has got the 50-hour exhaust bushing now, so hopefully it's going to not need to be serviced for a little while. It's going good. I'm pleased with it. I've been told I'm putting too much oil in. I've been running it at 40-1. Clive says I can dilute it a bit more than that. So that's what I'm going to do for the next lot of fuel. Andy's got a camera on the go on his flight today. It's Andy Bex. There's a nice van. Oh, look.
Hello.
Have I caught you on there?
Yeah, what have you been doing? You just caught me just in time.
Oh, did you have your trousers, Dave?
I did.
I saw you wearing shorts earlier. Yeah. So we're going to go for a quick flight, Andy, are we?
Yeah.
And how far are we open to go then?
Oh, we're just going to go towards Newbury. Into wind.
Into the wind, see how far we get.
Yeah, and
then bomb back.
And then bomb back, yeah.
That'd be good, wouldn't it?
Yeah, so just a little bit of fun for the evening, hopefully.
Yeah.
It's nice.
How are you finding your new motor then?
It's lovely.
You like that Atom 80?
Yeah, it's very good on fuel.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah.
And it's light as well.
It's a little bit lighter than my old one, yeah.
Yeah, so, very nice.
Got, nice and new and shiny. And
look after it.
Yeah. Andy's also got a Bulldog Spirit on Atom 80. These Atom 80s are becoming very popular motors. I got my brand new GoPro on the chest strap, but it just so happens that when I took off, the flight deck obscured the lens of the GoPro, so I can't get any video with my GoPro. My GoPro 7, that is. So what I have got is the Hero 4 on a selfie stick, and that'll have to do. I got the brakes parked, and all I'm doing for steering is called weight shifting. Basically, I'm just wiggling my backside. That's Segbury camp beneath me, apparently an Iron Age ill fort. I have actually camped there when I walked the Ridgeway. Yeah, I got sausages. Hey gentlemen, you're all being videoed, so on best behaviour. Hey, stop pushing me, you.
You've been framed.
So we've got a barbecue going on then.
Oh, hey Sandy, how are you?
How are you, alright?
Alright,
you bought yourself a clog, but you didn't give me one, did you?
Got one in there.
That's why.
Look at this, this looks lovely, doesn't it? Doesn't that look nice? Oh. Mm. Did you enjoy your flight home?
You don't wash the path when you're not cooked the path on.
Enjoy your flight.
Percentages switched late as I went on the new XX. I'm
gonna go to the mountain called the Fuji.
Old wing was 29.7 and it was a lot easier to reverse.
Anniversary.
Let's have a look.
It's 16th anniversary.
Oh, 16th wedding anniversary. Happy wedding anniversary to Phil and Liz.
70 quid.
I didn't know it was their wedding anniversary.
Yeah.
I paid for a cocktail, yeah.
Both of these are Paramotor pilots. I know it's a bit dark now. But this is where we're staying tonight. We're having a camp over at the Paramotor Club. I was so impressed with my Lanshan 1 tent that I went and purchased a Lanshan 2 as well. And this is brilliant. This is a two-man tent, the two-man version of it. I got this because my wife Mandy wants to join me on some of the expeditions and some of the things that I do. And this is one of them, coming out on a Paramotor meetup. And she might be doing a bit of hiking with me at some point, although she can't walk too far because she's got medical problems with her legs and her ankle. But I want to include her as much as I can. So that's the Lanshan 2, but I'll show you that a bit more later on, I expect. Paramotor's all packed away. The wing's in the boot of the car. The Paramotor is... covered over now. Hopefully we're going to go for a flight tomorrow. We're planning a 42-mile cross-country. So hopefully I'll be able to configure the camera so I can get a bit better footage for you. Well, here's the another little look at the Lanshan 2. My wife and I slept in here last night. It's a wonderful little tent. I really am very happy with it. It's got two entrances. I think it's very similar to the Z-Pax duplex. We had a bit of condensation last night because it was a very still night, but it's drying out really quick. And it's got two vestibules, so the other side's a mirror image of this side. The inner is just basically a fly screen, but at the head and foot ends you've got a solid piece of fabric, and there's also a little pouch to put your belongings in. Good bathtub area, as you can see. Looking up to the roof of the tent, it's got a little hook in the corner, and also up here another hook so you can have a little light up there. There's a good separation between the inner and the outer as well, as you can see. So that is the Lanshan 2. Motor's all fueled up. We're heading out for a 2-hour cross country. And there's all the others over there. Well, some good news and some bad news. First of all, the bad news. I had to come back to the field and land again. Because I had another engine problem, and I think it's Clive says it's carb icing. It happens quite a lot, actually. The engine's running okay, and then all of a sudden it starts to become a little bit lumpy and a bit intermittent. And this time I started getting surging. The power would increase, and then it would throttle back and then it would increase and throttle back. And all the time I'm swinging underneath the wing. And so I was taking off with Andy, I think it's Gary, and we were going to do a long journey. I had 10 litres of fuel on board. And I decided after about being airborne for about 10, 15 minutes that the engine started misbehaving. I thought, well, I'm not going to continue. So I turned back and came back, landed in the field safely. So that was the bad news. The good news is that I took off. And there's also another bit of good news. I actually got, after I landed, I actually then got to fly one of the Bulldog machines as well, with the Atom 80. Didn't get it on film. It was a completely different setup to me. It was higher hanging points. Not that much higher, but higher hanging points. The throttle was in the left hand, so I had to adjust to that. Different harness setup. But I must say, it was a very nice machine to fly. Much lighter, because of the smaller engine. And because of my weight, I'm 73 kilos. One of the reasons for the carb icing could be that the engine, my Master 185, is not running at full power, anywhere like full power. So with the throttle and the butterfly valve closed partially, the physics are that this increases the velocity of air through the carburetor, and the faster the air goes through, the cooler it becomes. And so if there's any moisture in the air, which there was, it's quite a damp morning, that moisture then freezes and starts clogging the carb up. So the thing is, my machine that I've currently got, the Maverick, is probably suited to a more heavier pilot, someone that weighs sort of 90 kilos perhaps. Be interesting to know if anyone else who's my weight, 73 kilos, flying a Maverick with a Master 185, is experiencing the same problems. If you are, please feel free to leave a comment. I'd be interested to find out. Anyway, there's Mandy. Look, we had a good night, didn't we, in the tent?
Yeah, oh, we did actually, yeah.
Yeah, we're just going to pack everything up now and then get ourselves back. We've got to go back and look after a horse, because our friend Lorraine, she's gone away for a few days and left me in charge of pony duties. So with that, I'll say thanks for watching. I do appreciate it, and I'll see you in my next one. Probably going to be, now I'm not sure what I'm up to. I've got something planned. I'll try and make it interesting, not only for you but for me. Not only for me but for you.
I'll go down then.